I'm Mike Stewart. I'm a professor of neuroscience. I've been at the Open University really since my PhD, and my main area of research is looking at Alzheimer's disease and neurodegeneration. But the other aspect of my work in teaching has involved teaching physiology and biopsychology, and I've been particularly interested in development of distance learning in medicine. I headed with Professor Janet Grant a team that was involved in trying to make a bid for the Open University to have a medical school, and although that didn't go ahead, subsequently with Janet I've been working in India and Bangladesh setting up distance learning courses. This project that I've been involved in since the beginning of the year is with Professor Gordon Williams. Gordon was a transplant surgeon from the Hammersmith Hospital and involved in the Royal College of Surgeons, and he's gone out to Addis Ababa to set up a medical school called St Paul's Millennium Medical School, because of course this is the millennium year in Ethiopia. Medical school has been funded in large part through Gordon's personal funds, but it's a project that has great support from within Ethiopia because they've got a major problem in training doctors. 95% of the doctors who train in Ethiopia go to the United States as soon as they qualify. They work there as taxi drivers while they're actually doing the US medical exams, and then they do their medicine within the United States. So they're very keen to train more doctors. And Gordon has set up this medical school so that he can get more doctors trained. What the Ethiopians hope to do is to have 9,000 new medical students, and they're setting up 11 medical schools throughout the country. Now, this has got a major problem because they simply don't have enough people to train the new students. So far, what Gordon has been doing in his medical school is to have people coming out from the United Kingdom, volunteer doctors who are actually going out and giving the lectures. And I've been out in Ethiopia twice with Janet Grant, and we've seen exactly what happens with the students. They're very high quality students, the training is of the utmost quality, but what they want us to do is to set up a distance learning program so that we can actually train doctors throughout Ethiopia and indeed in the various centres in around the country where the students will be located while they're in clinical attachments. Now this is very important, and it's got great support from the Ethiopian government. We've visited there very recently in the beginning of July, and we met Dr. Kabidi, who's the State Minister of Health. In fact, he partly supported our visit financially, and what they would like to do is now raise sufficient funds so that we can get this programme going on a large scale. We reckon we need around about £2.5 million to do this and to make it a project that really will have huge impact in Ethiopia. I think one of the things that's most interesting about it is it's not just, of course, in Ethiopia, but it could be a pan-African project, because Ethiopia is not the only country in Africa which suffers from not having enough doctors, enough medical practitioners throughout the country. So if this can work in Ethiopia, it'll work right across Africa. And it's fantastic that the Open University, with all its expertise, is being able to play a role in this. The major problem, of course, as I said, is attracting enough funding. The Vice-Chancellor's executive have approved this project, and now we're going outside to seek donor sponsors so that we can actually get the project initiated. Funding is the key issue for us, and clearly Ethiopia has very little money. In fact, they've got a famine at the moment, so they're short of everything right across the country. There are a large number of donors who are involved in programs in Ethiopia, and they're all very keen to help. But of course, what we need is direct money directed to the programs that we're specifically involved in. I know the Ethiopian government have actually approached the UK government, and indeed there have been discussions at the highest level as to how funding could be given so this project could go ahead. But I think it needs more than simply government support. I think we also need donor support from various agencies in the country, indeed individuals, if they feel they wanted to support this programme. It would be very welcome to have donations come to the Open University, to the Africa Office, which of course is coordinating the whole project through Danny and T, who's doing a splendid job in running the programme in the Open University. Thank you.